how these stones to become bread? Jesus answered, it is written, man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Then the devil took him to a holy city and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. If you are the Son of God, he said, throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. Jesus answered him, it is also written, do not put the Lord your God to the test. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. And brothers and sisters, isn't this what most people that are in the flesh want? They want to be on the top of the world. They want to be rulers of the world. They want to be recognized. This is something that we have today, right now. And it was then as well. All this I will give you, he said, if you will bow down and worship me. Jesus said to him, away from me, Satan, for it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only. And brothers and sisters, this is an important point right here. Because a lot of people think that they could have one foot in the world and one foot with Christ. And we see here that there's only one king and master that you could serve. Either you serve the devil or you serve Christ. But you can't serve both. Then the devil left him, and angels came and attended him. We see here a couple of things, brothers and sisters. First is how the devil manipulated or used God's word in order to try to persuade Jesus to serve him, to bow down before him. And the other thing, when he couldn't confuse or twist the words to Jesus, he had to resort to something else. And we see that he resorted to offering something, offering the kingdom. And this is what he does to us today. He tries to offer us something else. A lot of times you're working in something that's producing fruit. And the devil will bring something to your mind to deter you in a different direction. One of the things that, brothers and sisters, the Bible tells us about our enemy, the devil, it's found in Peter 5:8, and this is what it says. Be alert and sober mind. What that means, brothers and sisters, is that we need to be ready. Because you need to know his schemes, what he's trying to do. It says, your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Listen, we don't live in a perfect world. And I believe that every one of us have encountered someone that dislikes us for whatever reason. Maybe it was in school, growing up, at work, in the street, who knows? But there has always been, everybody has always encountered someone that doesn't like you for a reason But when we look at here, at this scripture, we see that the devil, he's just not somebody that's our enemy and doesn't like us. He's out on the prowl to destroy us. So what must we do? The Bible says in Ephesians 4:27, do not give the devil a foothold. And what that means is, do not give him an opportunity. Do not allow him to take you, confuse you, trick you, lie to you about anything. That's why, brothers and sisters, it's important that we know the scriptures. And more than that, we need to have a direct communication with Christ. We need to be in prayer. We need to understand what direction God wants for our life. Because a person that doesn't have an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ will be all over the place. Because they don't have an understanding of what God wants to do with them. We are to submit ourselves to God and resist the devil. And James 4:7 says, he will flee. Brothers and sisters, one thing that I could be sure of is that anybody who goes to war is going to come out with some scars. And when we look throughout the Bible, brothers and sisters, at the apostles, we see that every one of them was whipped, mistreated. Some were put to death, and others were left in an island to die there. What makes you think that you're not going to go through tribulation in this world? And it's very sad to say, brothers and sisters, but many people are teaching that, you know, as soon as you accept Jesus Christ, you know, nothing is going to happen to you. You're never going to have any problems. Well, I hate to differ with you. Every soldier that goes out there and battles in the fields, in the battlefields, every one of them have gotten scars. Some have even died. And you know something? Many of them have died for a flag. Isn't the cause of Jesus Christ greater than that? Jesus Christ called us, brothers and sisters, to proclaim his gospel, to proclaim his message. Every one of the apostles gave their life for that. Jesus gave his life so that we could be saved. That's how important this gospel is, brothers and sisters. And that's why this message of the Word of God needs to be taken to the ends of the world. Becoming a Christian is not something that has to do, such as a social club, for people to know you're a Christian, and it's about fun. It's about delivering a message. Today, we're living in a world, brothers and sisters, that we don't know if tomorrow this country or other countries are attacked with nuclear bombs. God doesn't only call us to save our family, but to save our neighbors. and even the ones that hate us. Are you doing that? Well, that's what a Christian should be doing. The same thing that Jesus did on that cross of Calvary. He fulfilled his Father's wish. He fulfilled his Father's command. And we are to fulfill our Master's command. It is our destiny. How would you feel if you went to heaven and you saw your neighbor, your father, your mother in hell? This reminds me of the story about Lazarus and the rich man. Once he found himself out there, he remembered his family. Listen, if you give me an opportunity and I could speak to them, I could go back and tell them about how it is here. It's too late. Now's your time. It is a time to be able to proclaim the good news.
Love.